guys, it is Sunday the 25th, I believe. I apologize if it isn't. But the 25th of September, and I'm up. It is obviously 6:30 in the morning. Yeah. Jassy's being a bad girl. Well, no, I'm trying to see how I'm like, you know, if I can't sleep to be, and I'd rather be productive to do that. I'm actually attempting, please don't drop this phone in the coffee, attempting to drink black coffee with, what is it, Splenda? It isn't that bad, really. Yeah, I know, Jazz is going to become a coffee junkie, and more else will go wrong with her brain. That coffee probably should be one of the only things go away from your brain. But when you think about it, I've drinking caffeine with ice caps, with pop. What worse can coffee do? You know what, I probably shouldn't be saying that. Because I particularly remember one time, though this is an old story, I may have been like 9 or 10? Maybe even 11 or 12, but forget the age, I was young, inexperienced. But I remember going with my Aunt Kathy, we'll call her, the one that lives with me, yeah, eventually I have to know her name instead of my aunt, took me camping out in the island, I think. Or is it Big Island? It wasn't Prince Edward Island. I don't know what island it was. Oh, it may have been PEI, actually, now that I think about it. But anyway, the point is, and then before I continue, you're probably, some of you are probably thinking, I thought you were reclusive in your own little world, in your room. And yes, majority of the time I am. But when I was a kid, I was a little more open. For some reason, I don't know. I think with me, it just got worse. If autism spectrum disorder is the cause, then for me, it just got worse over the years. Where they say it tends to in their teen through adult years. But anyway, my point is, I remember I went to the island with her, and I was at an age where I had never had coffee, and she always drank it, and I begged her to let me try a cup of coffee, like I wanted my first cup of coffee, and she was hesitant at first, right? Obviously, I mean, she wasn't my mom, and what would my mom think if I came, if she told her I came caffeinated and, like, jittery or whatever? So I ended up trying it, and, like, she did give me that warning, you know, that feeling when you first have it. Oh, was it bad? I believe it gave me nightmares, too. Now you're probably thinking, why am I drinking it? I mean, I was a kid, too, back then. And like, I'm not saying this won't have any effect on me, but it wouldn't be into that degree now. For one, I'd probably drink in a lot of things with, even if with a little bit with caffeine, and have had some sort of caffeine intake, especially with the ice caps I have had. And I thought, just one sugar twin, you know, something to give me a little more energy. Maybe I should try that if I wake up in the day, you know, just to get me out. A lot of adults do it. Let me guess. Oh my god, Jazz, you're turning into an adult. Even though you've technically been an adult for, like, 7 years? I do not know, actually. If you consider adulthood in your 20s, and I've only been almost 5 years, but if you consider it in 18, and yeah, 7 years, I've been chronologically, I think, an adult. And now you're thinking, you're becoming an adult, getting the taste for coffee. Now you've definitely become an adult. Yeah, trust me, guys, I have not. Trust me, if I was an adult, I'd be able to think things through before panicking and not overthink situations. And something like work wouldn't be a issue for me. I mean, at all, without even, like, put it this way. Where I work has modifications, right? It isn't, it is a work place. It is important, everything we do. That's not where I'm going with. But compared to, like, the jobs, like, going to a restaurant or going into the office and that, it isn't a high-maintenance job. Yet, I have trouble going to where I'm, Summer Street. So, yeah, I am far from being an adult. Just saying. Sometimes you wonder, though, once you start doing something, are you an adult or are you growing up? Yeah, besides that, I'm watching my... I believe, I don't know if you'll see it, but, well, can't really see it, but I'm watching my top 5 favorite 3DS games. Sometimes I do like going over it, not for views, I just like to watch them. I mean, I said, like, it's funny, like, earlier today, I was looking at some of my old YouTube videos, and you're thinking, you're looking back to your other channels? No, I was not. Unless someone dares me to, I'm not looking back on them again. I mean, I'm trying to think. Starting December, I've been doing it for 3 years, almost, and I'm going on year... Well, actually, no, I've been around for more, a little longer than that. I've been around for about 3 years, in a way, almost. But technically, either in December, I will either be going on year 3 or year 4. I'm actually starting to lean towards year 4, I think, because... I started in December of 2013, although that was almost 2014, so, no, I really think I might be going on to year 3. My memory is not really good, but I know it was December 14-ish, 2013, which was just before 2014 that I really started, like, getting serious into the channel. And, okay, my content wasn't really good, but I was trying to do a serious thing, like, try to keep it up. I've had my ups and downs where I didn't upload and that, but when you think about it, for at least 2 years almost, maybe even a full year, I've been going pretty strong. And I'm hoping that I can do this for a long time. But I honestly don't know how long this will go. As I said, I want to figure out how it'll affect my life overall. Now, trust me, I've been getting positive, nothing but positive on this. For the most part, that's with my work. I've gotten constructive criticism, but that is actually what I needed to get going. I've made some, I feel, legitimate friends on this site, too. But when I say how it affects my life, it means how it affects everything else. Now, when you think about it, when it comes to my YouTube life and me doing videos, for the most part, I just feel great doing them. I have my odd moments where I'm like, I don't feel like doing something, but that is rare that it's that bad that I don't feel like doing anything. Where it's affecting other areas of my life because I think this has kind of become my life in a way. And not that I don't appreciate or care about others, but that kind of became my routine. So it will just take a while for... I know where my channel is going 100%, because when you think about it, except for, yes, there's emulators involved in some of them, quite a few of them, but when you think about it, a lot of this costs money. Okay, not the upload. The uploading YouTube thing is free. It technically costs money for the things like the headphones, the microphone. In fact, I had to stop Adobe, as you've learned weeks back. I mean, I don't know how far back, but weeks back. You need money for new games that aren't the DS or Game Boy or Color GBA. So, that's anything from 3DS on. You'll need new games if I want to play it for a certain system. And if they're ever, and someday I may want a new system, for example. So, when you think about it, there is a lot that I can offer, but at the same time, I have to really learn to get out of my comfort zone a lot more. And I have improved in it. I think what I want to do is fully, you know, love what I'm doing. Every time I do it, I'm like, and I'm not saying that I don't love playing games. I do, trust me. The problem I think with me is sometimes I love it so much that, like, sometimes the fact that I have to record the game can sometimes get in the way. Because I'd be feeling like playing a game, but then I'm like, I have to get out the cable, or I have to get the emulator off, or I have to get my earphones and my microphones on, and I'm all hooked to the computer now. Okay, I'm not literally hooked, for those who might take me a little too literally. But when you think about it that way, it isn't always fun that way when you want to just play a game and you have to really get yourself connected and find things and then turn on the game. And then by the time you do all that, oh, hey guys, just recording this because I kind of want to play it. What was the last time? Okay, I am exaggerating that, how unenthused it is. But that's kind of an idea. Like, games are a passion for me. And maybe it's also because I'm still getting out of my comfort zone, not with just games, but with speaking, with commentary. Because when you think about it, when you're recording a game, that's the other point I was trying to get to, but this is still going where I'm going. Sometimes I want to play a game without having to worry about talking over it. All the time. Right, and every time I have to play, if I have a file specifically for my Let's Play, I need to use it for my Let's Play. I can't just get it out, just play a little bit of it. Or I might miss storyline. Type of thing. Like, I'm lucky I decided to stop the Super Mystery Dungeon Let's Play as it is. Because I decided that I'm still going to, like, I'm not, and I never uploaded it, so it's not really announced as a Let's Play. It might be called, like, you might hear it, but I'm going to use it as footage, because I do have a review coming up in the future for it. But anyway, and maybe that's why I'm starting to enjoy Super Mystery Dungeon a little bit better, because I've actually taken time and really focused on it. And I enjoy doing that. I just really seem to love doing reviews and just sitting down and playing games. And I still do occasionally enjoy Let's Play too, because it sometimes adds magic to the game too. So it's something that I'm really going to have to decide where it goes, and this is a vlog entry, and I'm talking all about an update. I might have to make a separate update on that, but I just don't know, like, really what to cover in an update right now, because I have a lot of videos ahead scheduled to upload, which is kind of a blessing for me now, because with all that done, I can kind of, you know, work on other projects, just play that game and relax a little more. And I still try to look for your comments. I still look at your comments if you leave them and make suggestions. That always helps, right? But I try to post-record a lot of my games. Now, like I said, I will have a few that might be newer being uploaded and others not so much. Anyway, guys, I'll see you in the next clip. Hey, guys, it's me again in the vlog. I thought I would let you know that I might be doing a special project back and forth, and I'll be telling you how it's going. It's just going to be a special video I'm going to give you guys, and I figure this video might help me with others as well. It would take a while to do because it'll not only require game footage, but my narration as well, and a lot of editing skills, which I don't have very much, but it'll just bring more awareness, will they say, to a certain situation with me. So, I'll bring you back and forth with it. I'll see you in the next clip. Hey guys, it is Monday, the 26th of September. First of all, happy birthday. I think it was today or yesterday. But anyway, happy birthday to my cousin Kaylee. She is 8 today. And what else was I going to say? Well, we've worked out something. Like, originally, I was having trouble with going to work. But next week, I'm going to try to go to work, and there'll be some adaptations. I'm going to hear more about that tomorrow from my supervisor, Spirit Riser. So, what was I going to say? I'm also trying a new sleep routine. I'm not staying up all night. That was foolish of me. I am set in my ways, but I admit, so far, I fell asleep last night at like 9 o'clock, 8:39. Woke up at 2 once, but went back to sleep. And I did pretty good. I feel pretty good. I never did any videos yet, but it'll take me a while to get into a day routine. But I'm doing a lot better that way. Now, geez, I forget what I was going to say. But I didn't really do much today. I mean, even though for being awake all day from 11:30 on, I didn't really do very much. But eventually, y'all get into that productive frame of mind, hopefully. Sorry for the lack of, like, video footage in the last little bit. I was just going through a bit. Like, as I said, I didn't get sleep at all until 8 yesterday, so. But I will try to get back into doing more and recording footage for you guys. I really want to put as best effort into my channel as possible, but still do things that I love to do. I have to still set in the frame of mind, I was saying to my aunt that if I don't continue with something, it won't continue for the most part. So I have to work on my routine to get it kind of right, because I'm going to speed up more hours now, in a better way. So I will have more time to do things. I just have to get on doing them. Like, I'm thinking of videos that I could be making. Like, I do need to record more South Park Stick of Truth for certain. But I really am in the mood to record The Sims. And you're not going to get a recording footage of that right now, because I thought I would do a quick update tonight, because I'm on and off with how I'm feeling. I'm feeling good in some ways, in others, not as much. One, I got a stuffy nose and my stomach's bothering me. The other way, wise, pretty good. How was I going to say it? Like as I said, I want to record when I'm in the mood for something. Not saying that I should record other videos later, but right now I'm more in the mood for The Sims, but at the same time I'm not. I just kind of am one of those funks, right? And someone brought up about The Walking Dead Season 2. I will get to recording that. The thing is, I can record a lot in advance, but I want to have an idea when a certain Let's Play is going to be over. For example, I don't know when South Park Stick of Truth is going to be over. And I'm using that as a main Friday LP. I want to substitute Walking Dead Season 2 for South Park. But thing is, until I know that I'm almost done recording, like the South Park Stick of Truth, I don't want to start recording The Walking Dead, because the South Park Stick of Truth will be months in advance. So I still want to be on top of The Walking Dead Season 2, but I don't want to record too much that I can't upload. Because I don't want to start scheduling that upload until after the South Park Stick of Truth is done. And I know it's going to be done. So, that is the issue there. And that's why it wasn't on the uploads, because I didn't really see any future of it at this point. Because I don't know when a good date is to upload it. Because, I don't know, I consider that one of my main, the bigger LPs. Just like The Legend of Zelda that I've been uploading starting February. But I had an idea for that already. It was already done. I knew an idea when I was going to upload it. So that is the reason why that is up. That's going to be a second big LP, because I'm almost done of what I want to do for it. And South Park is still going a bit. I'm still needing to record that, even though it's into like November, December almost. I still have a lot to record. I'm in the middle of it, but it's near the ending that it's really difficult. So you might see me get frustrated quite a bit. Hooray! I mean, I've been getting better at battling, like in that sense, but I still struggle. As I said, there's moments where I'm like, oh my god, this can't be done. But anyway, I think that's about it. Like, well, there was one cute moment, though. I never got to record it, but it just came out of the blue. I was talking to my aunt sitting on the couch, and suddenly my dog, Leah, I'll show a picture, you never saw her for a little bit, literally put her head underneath my arm and snuggled against my chest area. And she was just laying there all snuggly, and I'm like, really, I never got that moment. At all. Oh well. Things happen. Sometimes things happen and you don't have a camera, which is a shame, but it was just so cute. She was all lovey-dovey-dovey snuggling against me. As I said, first time she's gotten that into me. Right? I'm thinking, oh, I'm taking it. I'm like, snuggle, snuggle, snuggle. Literally, it was like I was not squeezing her tight where it hurt her, but it's like I was hugging her. Right? Just the position my arm was in. Speaking of, there's my dog barking. Anyway, guys, I will see you in the next clip. Hey, guys, it is Tuesday, September 27th, and I feel like hell, I'll just say it. I apologize for the language. Literally didn't get any sleep last night, and I tried, trust me. Let's just say that the cold chose a bad time to come up. I know TMI, I apologize to those who get squeamishly or whatever, but literally, it's so bad that when I sneeze, a bunch of snot comes out. And the thing is, it's not like I sneeze once in a while. I'm lucky right now I'm not sneezing, but I probably just jinxed myself. I definitely decided I am not doing any videos besides this, like, little thing here today, because if I were to try to set up and do a narrated video, I would be sneezing every few minutes, and I wouldn't be able to continue. That's just the fact. I bet I'm better off just watching videos, playing games without really focusing on talking. I said I wouldn't be able to talk today. I mean, I don't know if you could tell that I'm congested. I never thought I would say this. I said Sunny D looks good. I don't usually drink orange juice at all, but hopefully my aunt will come bring back some in the next, several hours. She's at work, so there's nothing I can do besides drink water and use toilet paper. There's not even Kleenex. Yeah. But I called Summer Street, obviously. Like, I need to talk to one of the staff. Anyway, I was supposed to at 12, but I thought I was up. I might as well get it out of the way, for I could just, like, not go to sleep, because I have to stay up, because I was up, so I could just relax, and not think of anything else. Heck, I think a bowl of homemade soup sounds good, too. Yeah, literally, I thought it may have been just the air conditioner, right? But, nope, it's a cold. I mean, if you hear noise, it is my humidifier. I don't know if you see it, but it's there. Finally got a good shot of something. Hopefully that'll make a little difference. I had it on for a few hours, so not much, but it doesn't help that I don't really blow traditionally. I try. It just, nothing works. The worst thing about this is I can't find the nasal stuff. I cannot find any vapor. You know, the one with the green lid, which I don't usually use, but I would have tried today. So anything that could possibly help me, except for the cold tablets, which, trust me, they have been working very well for me. They have, like, everything else doesn't seem to be there. No Sunny D, no vapor, no nasal spray. It's gonna be a several, I don't know what to call it, I mean, once it's 12, it's 4 hours till she gets home, so it's only 9, so a long time, I tell ya. And I'm gonna have to put up with this for several hours. Well, I said I would show ya, I'm showing ya at one of my worst. And I'm not kidding, I said not, like, imagine being really congested, being tired, but not being able to sleep because of you being really congested. Yeah. One other thing that was mentioned I could try would probably make me pass out. And the only other thing I could probably do for myself is drink a lot of fluids. Or liquids. Or is it liquids or fluids? Well, I don't know. So I'll be drinking water. That's probably the only thing I could do for myself today that would help a little bit. And I guess I could move around when I get the water. Besides that, there's really nothing else that will help me that won't hurt me any further. And what they suggested to do was to literally plug the tip of your nose, right? And take a deep breath and briskly walk for so long, 20, 40 steps max. And then uncover your nose and breathe slowly through your nose. I wouldn't be able to handle that. I'd pass out. I mean, as I said, they said it's supposed to clear your airway because you're using that as your breathing source. Mostly. I don't know. Honestly, it's funny how all the steps they mentioned there, a couple of them are unsavory for me. I don't like putting soap on my nose. Like vapor you don't have to put on your nose, but I don't have it. Well, let's hope the rest of this week will go better, because I really want to get to work next week. And I don't want to be stopped because of a cold. I mean, yes, anxiety is legit, right? I mean, that is a legitimate reason, like, in my case, but I don't want to... Like, if I can get there, I want to get there. Because I've been off way too long already for this. Hey, guys, it is Wednesday, September 28th. And I'm trying a new Five Alive Tropical Citrus. It's not bad. I don't really like the what is it, pineapple or peach. I forget what it is. I'm not good with recognizing certain fruits because I don't eat many. But I have a cold, obviously. So I'm going to try to drink some more. There is no Sunny D, so maybe I can enjoy something different. Maybe I can rebuy this or something, because maybe I should incorporate more vitamin C and to my day, for I won't get colds as bad as I do. Thing is, I don't get colds, like, often, like some people, but when I get it, it hits me hard. So, I'd rather those mini, like, frequent mini colds than what I get. Although, the good news is, it's only my nose being really badly affected this time around, but even that, it's a pretty bad one. As I said, this isn't too bad. End taste is a little bit strong, but besides that, it isn't bad. I didn't do too good sleep-wise. Well, I did good. I fell asleep early. It's just I was taking a new cold or allergy medication, and the good news is it worked. The bad news is it made me drowsy. I'm shocked I'm not so drowsy now because it took a second. Maybe it's just the first one that's really strong. I have no idea. But I know that it was that pill that, like, I took it at, I was up at, like, 9-something, and 8 or 9, I forget the exact time there. I took the cold, or allergy, it's called allergy tablet, which is, like, so small, but I'm not showing that in my video. I don't want to show any medication in my video, but it's still it was tiny, though. It was a thick pinkish, I don't know what color, but it was like that small. I took a pill that small, and I couldn't even focus. I texted my aunt saying that I will try to go to bed the same time I've been doing, you know what I mean, like I did last night. But I'm not going to force myself to stay awake when I'm not even functionable. I mean, there actually was a difference between the day I was up all day and that pill, the effects of that pill. When I was up all day, like, before, I was in a bad mood, right? I was tired, but I could somewhat function, right? I was alert. But when I took that allergy tablet this morning, like, I would literally, like, look at, like, for example, when I'm pointing at that wall for a good 2-3 minutes. And I was out of it. Literally. I mean, imagine looking at a wall for 2 or 3 minutes, and that could be every few seconds. I would look at another area and not do anything, just... Well, maybe what I'm... You kind of get the idea I'm going for. And I was like, Thing is, I couldn't even focus on, like, if I was playing The Sims, for example, I couldn't even focus on that. Because I literally went into blank space for, like, a minute to 3 minutes at a time sometimes. And if it was that heavy, then I couldn't stay awake. I wouldn't be able to, unless I was just staring in air for 4 or 5 hours. So I didn't fight it. I mean, I couldn't. As I said, like, and I was afraid taking another one of them, what they would do to me. But at the same time, I want some relief for my nose. Right? And it does work. I mean, it's not as good as it was earlier, but that's probably because I was more drowsy earlier. But it does work, and I'll just have to think of something else when I go back into work that I could take, or something that will help relieve it if I have that issue by then. Because I'm worried that at least when I'm at home, I don't have to really focus on anything when I take that, right? I mean, I still, like, I would have preferred to be able to remain focused, right? But it wouldn't be as big of a deal. But, I mean, it was, like, have you ever had a situation that was so euphoric but awful at the same time? That's what that medication did. I didn't feel like crap in any way, shape, or form, but what was awful was the fact that I couldn't, like, keep myself awake because I couldn't focus. Even if I was sitting up, I would easily fall asleep sitting up. So, I'm like, what's the point, really? But I'm hoping I'll get used to taking the medication that it will still work, but it won't make me songed out. Because I'm telling you, it was more weird feeling. Like, just being out of it where you would literally just move your head in a certain direction and keep it there for a certain length of time without even noticing. And I literally would have to shake my head to get myself out of it. Have any of you guys had that issue with a medication before? Whether it's a allergy tablet or whatever it is you might take? That literally it helps relieve what you're taking. It does a job in a way, what you're taking it for, but at the same time, it makes you almost unfunctionable. That, I'd like to know down below if it is too private. As I said, I won't show any medication on here too much, because this is, I mean, it has to, I want it to be allowable on YouTube, and I'm trying to really think about what is allowable and what is not. I might say a few words here or there, but it's not going to be anything crazy. Speaking of crazy, though, before I end this clip, what are you guys thinking of that YouTube hero thing? Me, I have two feelings about it, or two ways of thinking about it. One, it is incredibly stupid. And two, I mean, I get where they're trying to go with it. Like, I mean, I get what they want to accomplish, but it is still stupid. I mean, the thing is, you're given power over almost anyone. I mean, anyone. Come on. I mean, it's bad enough what your computers are doing to us. I mean, at least as much as I would argue, oh, this rule is stupid or something sometimes, at least when you guys do it, whether it's computer or YouTube, a YouTube sponsor, they have already a set of rules, right? And they will always follow those rules. So if there is not a certain action or word allowed to be used, or copyright, if you're copying the content that is not allowed to be copied, then I see that the rules are programmed into those computers, and the ones who do it manually themselves are trained there, and no bias, just that they broke a rule. If you give the power to, let me say, a 14-year-old, they'll say, ah, this video isn't as good as mine. What is in it that I could flag it? Ah, they said one bad word. Flag. I mean, really. You're literally giving power to just about anyone, including a kid. No offense, I know kids these days are very intelligent, but they lack... I'm trying to think. They sometimes, not all of them, there's some that are exceptional in that area too, but a lot of kids lack the... And I sometimes do too. I'm trying to think of how to explain it. They lack the... I'm still trying to think of the right words. That's what I hate about... don't take it the wrong way. I don't hate myself. But that's one thing I kind of hate about myself, because sometimes I don't know how to say it the way I like that it's coming up as, but it just, they don't come out right. They lack the... I'm just trying to think of the right word. I have other words in my head, like responsibility. They lack the ability, I'll just say it. They lack the ability to know that their actions have consequences. Well, they kind of do. Like, okay, they don't have the ability to comprehend that it'll affect, like, their actions can affect others, too. They have basic understanding of that, but if it's something like a YouTube video or whatever, some of them lack the ability to also understand, right? That, okay, you guys kind of get where I'm going for, because I can't word it right, and I've been trying for a while. But, I mean, the point is they haven't matured enough to really take that responsibility seriously, is what I mean. And some adults are like that, too. I mean, like, I'm not the type that I listen and I do read the rules a little bit. But, I mean, if, let's say I was one of those computers or one of the workers on YouTube, I wouldn't just flag something because it's competition, right? I would, and when, if I did, I would make sure the rules that it's like that the video is really breaking any of those rules, like to a certain extreme. I mean, some people will just flag it for almost nothing. Like, there's some people who are offended by small curse words, let's say, like damn or crap, for example, or even stupid. Some people don't even like that. And they'll say, oh, this video is saying curse words, this. And, like, let's hope that maybe in the future with this YouTube Heroes things, that the actual company of YouTube will have a really good look at why a video is being flagged before giving power or, like, rewarding the person for flagging it or even, or doing something about it. Because, like, it's good that they have the right idea, like, their meaning well, I think, but they just aren't thinking about it the right way. Obviously, I don't know how the rules are, but I think... And then again, they can never know for sure if someone is lying or not. But I think that for YouTube Heroes, they should make a rule that only allows that power to someone 18 or over. Right? And if they're not sure if the person is really that age, then maybe if they have an account, like with videos, to watch a few of them, look for either face or significant voice. You know what I mean? That way, or maturity. But I mean, I suppose if they're just having a channel where they watch videos, that's hard to tell too. But honestly, like, or even maybe check the person's activity, whether like someone has commented their age or something, or the way they act. I mean, I know that can't always be correct of indicating age, but another way you could think about it is, if that person is acting that way, then they're not responsible enough to take a serious role in that. I mean, whether they look for age or the behavior of someone before allowing them to do it, that they should. I mean, as I said, YouTube heroes can be an okay thing if it was handled in the way kind of how I was describing it. Because there's too many people these days that are abusing that. And I mean, as I said, I like freedom, right? And I really have asked, where's the freedom? But at the same time, like, I can understand, like, with everything that YouTube has been doing, yes, what has been happening is stupid, but I can still somewhat understand where, like, what they're trying to do, but I can't understand that, like, how fragile they're being about it. I mean, I know there are really bad things out on the internet, right? That if, like, say I had a child, I wouldn't want them to see. But if YouTube is flagged something as simple as acne, then they're being way too sensitive. I mean, I also understand that sometimes things like war stories can be sensitive to certain people. But oftentimes, it's kind of mentioned or warned if someone's going to be doing something like that, so that person can just avoid that video. I think having the ability to talk about things like that is important. I mean, okay, and I'm not going to try to say it in a way that I will get this section banned, but if someone were to say, oh, I watched a video and this person effed this other person, or I went right up to this guy and you got, know what I mean? I mean, things like that, I can see they wouldn't want on their site. If the person was being intentionally rude or intentionally doing that to gross people out and knowing it's wrong. But there's some people who are just talking about their day or how their life was, and they're not meaning any malice. Like, they don't have any malice intent. And they were just talking about, oh, they're and their buddies from the war went out to one of the local pubs, for example. Like, I mean, I think it's all on how the person says the things and how, like, in the way they say it and, like, in the tone, in the way, everything like that. Like, for someone like me, it's also hard to always get my point across. Like, like, hopefully next week I'll be getting back into work. And one thing I mentioned to my aunt is that I may be articulate in a way. I know a lot of big words, that's kind of an example. But sometimes I do not know how to fully articulate exactly how I'm feeling. I mean, I know that normal people have that problem too, or individuals, what they call, what is it? I don't 100% know if I am actually autistic, but I'm definitely not, what is it, what do they call it? I'm not going to say the word normal anymore, because that is too judgmental, I think. What is it? Neurotypical. All right, the people who are, I'm definitely not neurotypical, but we'll just say the people who are neurotypical have that issue too, to an extent, but let's just say some people, let's say they had a headache or something. Some person, like, sometimes people can describe what that headache is. Like, oh, it's pounding like a certain word, for example. Me, I could just say I have a headache, but if I try to go into further detail of how bad that headache is, I would be confused into who I'm talking to. I mean, but anyway, I was gonna say, like, yeah, I never got fully affected by the YouTube hero thing yet, but, and I'm not saying that it isn't a bad thing too, but we'll just say that it's being handled poorly is the biggest thing. And if the only way I can 100% respect it is if things would change, and maybe not exactly in the route I was saying, but in a way that, like, but I'm sure if someone from YouTube was watching this, they would kind of get where I was going at. Like, I know sometimes it's hard to take precautions, right? Because, it's like, you can never tell if someone's just making a fake account. But, like, for example, like, the last thing I was going to say, for me, I sound and I do look young. So, like, someone might not give me powers because of how I sound, for example. If they were doing it that way. But, I mean, I'm not really that type of person. I mean, I wouldn't even notice if something was bad unless it was those examples I used before, right? I'm not the judgmental type of person, so of course I wouldn't be good with that power. Because I just wouldn't be able to sit long enough to really judge if it's bad or not. But let's just hope YouTube goes into the right direction. I will see you in the next clip. Hey guys, it is Thursday, September 29th, and I am going to record a Pokemon White session for you guys. It was a long time since I recorded it, so I'm getting it ready. The game is running. And while I'm doing that, I might talk a little bit in this, like, episode and stuff about different things I'm feeling, so... Okay. And we're on here, and I want to get the whole sea gear out of the way. Alright guys, here we go. What's up friends, this is Jazz, bringing you another episode of Let's Play Pokemon White. In the last episode, we defeated Elisa for the Volt Badge, is it? I don't know really, I forget the badge's name, but I think it is Fold. Let's just look at my Oh, it's the Bolt badge. Okay. Not shiny enough, so get shinier. Trying to get it shiny, shiny, shiny new. Trying to get it shiny, shiny, shiny new. La la. Anyway, guys, this time I wanted to give you a little bit on what I believe is the most famous case in history, the Jean Bonnet case. It happened 26 years ago in Barbado. I forget what, Barado, I think. And it happened on Boxing Day of 1996. What happened was is that there was a ransom note that Patricia Ramsey found that said that her daughter was kidnapped and you needed to follow the letter to a T if you wanted to get her back alive. And, well, that they said they'd call between 8 and 10, but they never did. And tragically, at about 1:01, I think, Jean Bonnet's father discovered her in the basement boiler room. And that's just the beginning of that whole tragedy. It really went on for, like, forever. 26 years to this, not to this day, 26 years... You know, and hold on, I want to check if something is working. Hello! Yeah, I was testing to see if my recording session was working, so... But yeah, you're probably wondering my opinion on it. Pretty much, I think that the brother, Burke, she had a brother. I believe he did it because he used to be the center of his parents' eyes until Joan Bonnet was born. She was also a beauty pageant, so yeah, of course she'd get a lot of spotlight. Also, before we go on, I'm going to show you any changes to the team. We got Wilma's fully evolved, which is great. And I need to heal up everyone else. I'm going to heal everyone up, and I'm going to level up them, so I will be back. Oh, yeah, I accidentally did the thing. Yeah, guys, I made a boo-boo. All YouTubers have this amateur thing to them, so please forgive me. There. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go in and heal them up just to start with. And then I'm going to go back to going out. I'm going to get them maybe level 35, 36. But you know what, I think I will bring the thing back up. So... Hey guys, I made a bit of a mistake. I apologize to you deeply. But I'm gonna go and level up my Pokemon now, so I will be back. And what we have to do here, guys, is obviously use the rare candy, which is so much better, I tell you. Because, oh, mighty water, what can I get with you, buddy? Ooh. You know what? I know what I'm doing today. Yeah, muddy water. Yeah, my hat's on funny. Yeah, and that's the most annoying thing ever. You know what? I'm not using rain dance, actually. And I'm bringing 36 into the picture. And we're having an evolution, folks. Guys, we're having Ganon's evolution at level 36, obviously. We're going to get another level 36 evolution. Hallelujah. This guy should help us greatly in the battle against Clay. May lower special defense. Are you serious? Just for that chance? No. I'm not risking that. But honestly, guys, like, that's what I go through every day. I think I will end this clip off now. I will see you guys next time. Hey guys, it is Saturday the 1st, I believe, of October. I cannot believe it's already the 1st of then. In 9 days, I'm going to be 25. Maybe I'll record it. I'll record some things of my birthday. Anyway, what was I going to say? I did quite a bit today. I tidied up my room a little bit. Yeah, I didn't think of recording that. I apologize. I recorded some Pokemon White. I recorded some Super Mystery Dungeon. Now, guys, this is not going to be... The Super Mystery Dungeon is not going to be a Let's Play. As I said in my update, it is... I mean, I record it, but it's so difficult to record... Like, to make it... To put a priority as a Let's Play for it. It's hard enough for me to make a priority to sometimes record it. Like, I play it. I'm playing it for a review. I'm just, like, re-going over it. And I don't play it every second of every day. I record a bunch of it, but I don't... Like, I play a bunch of it, but I don't record it. And then if there's a necessary scene that I would like in my review, right? Then I would record that section of the game. But when you think about it, if I was recording the entire gameplay, I might as well make it a Let's Play. And two, I would never get it done. I need to have time to play it myself without making commentary over it. But for certain events, like the main big change, like game-changing boss battles, then I will battle it. Like, I just recorded my battle against Ante and when they use their scarves to evolve. And that is a major part of the story, so I recorded that. And trust me, it was kind of funny me trying to record it and trying to concentrate all at the same time. I put it this way. I recorded it since the beginning of the battle against Magmortar and Magmar. Then after that is one battle against Ante. Then another battle against Ante. Now put it this way. If something goes wrong with any of them, I have to go back and go through the dialogue again. The thing is, it wouldn't be so bad if it was just against Magmortar, maybe. But imagine if I beat Magmortar struggling, and I did in that battle. I struggled more than against Ante at this point. I struggled to beat Magmortar and his Magmar, and then I thought, oh my god, what happens if I lose to Ante? That I have to do Magmortar again and do Ante again, and oh my god. Right? So I ended up being lucky. I ended up finding it easier against Ante than against the Magmortar and that. Maybe because Ante is all on his own, as much at high as dangerous as his stats are. Although, I find that the easiest battle for me was probably the second battle against Ante, because I had my evolution and I just aligned to attack the hell out of him. I finally learned the grace of the alliance attack. Not that I didn't kind of know about it last time, but I played through it otherwise. When you think about it, though, like, the evolved Pokemon were stronger using their regular attacks, but still, alliance attack can really come in handy when you know how to use it. And so can items. Trust me. I've brought a lot of items with me that I would never bring in my other games, like Confuse Wands, for example. If you know there's going to be a boss Pokemon, like a strong one at the end, like a end of a dungeon, bring those items. Bring as many as you can fit that will stun the enemy, or, you know, I'd be like temporarily take the danger away from you, and then figure it out from there. Like, there's some battles that, stupidly enough, say an items don't work or something, and that's just weird, but. Some items work. Like, I know I confused Ante, for example, and he would be confused, which would help, too, because he'd go, like, moving around, and you get to attack him. The only downside is I think it stuns him out of his confusion after an attack, I think. I can't remember. Not, like, with him, it was that way anyway. Maybe because he was a legendary or something. I don't know. But anyway, my point is, I'm, like, past chapter 4, or 14, I think I'm on chapter 14, maybe almost chapter 15 of the game, and there still is quite a bit to go. Like, yes, this was a big hurdle for me, but trust me, there are more. There's worse. The good news is, I believe, I can't remember. No, maybe not. I thought maybe, I think you're in your regular forms when you're battling Yveltal. God, I hope I'm wrong. I'm gonna have to research that. Because that battle enough, not only will I have to struggle playing it, I'll have to struggle recording it. Because that's one of the biggest battles in the game. Besides against the final non-Pokemon battle. It's really not a Pokemon you're battling. It's an entity of some sort. And I may have just used that in the wrong contents. But kind of like, I think entity means some type of god, right? Some type of being. I don't really know, but I mean, it's different from Pokemon, so an unknown force, that is the best way to word it. And that is annoying, but I think the best thing about it is that you can keep going back, and eventually it gets easier, I think. But so far I'm not doing too as bad second time around playing that game as I did the first time, maybe because I'm being more careful with using my items. Although, speaking of, I might have to go item scavenging again. Yeah, I know. I mean, this is like, I think, my 18th vlog. You'll miss Friday, but that's about it, I think. Because, like, and hopefully Monday I'll be back at work. And maybe, hopefully, I'll do well enough to kind of grieve, because when you think about it, the first 2 weeks wasn't as bad. I felt a little guilty not going, but now I'm at a point where I'm thinking it's a big part of my life, right? And when you think about it, if I don't have that, all I have is the channel. And even the channel, like, once in a while, like, you want to do, like, it's hard to explain. Guys, or even if you make a lot of money from it, you still should have social lives as well. Right? But especially if it's a hobby. Well, not a hobby. It could be a passion of someone, and that's alright, like it is to me. But you should find other interests, too. I still struggle with that. And it's something for me to look back on as well, this vlog. Like, I really need to find another thing that I'm passionate about as well, so I can feel proud in all areas. Because it feels good doing all these videos and such, but YouTube can be a tough thing. Because no matter how hard someone works, it doesn't mean that it doesn't eventually pay off, right? There's people who do really well and still, like, they work hard and they do really well. But sad to say, there's a lot of talented YouTubers out there that are not recognized for what they are. Like, there could be YouTubers that have a great personality. They may not have the flashiest quality or the equipment, but they have the heart in it, and they don't get recognized. Like there's a few YouTubers I know that have, like, only 50-something subscribers that could easily have in the thousands, and they work really hard on it. Like, and as I said, like, I'm not saying this to... Like, I'm trying to think. What I'm about to say is not to sound cocky at all, but it is truth. There may be days where I don't seem to have as much motivation, but a majority of the time, every day I try to get one or two, maybe even three videos done. And I do work hard on them, even though it doesn't always seem that way. And once in a while, as I said, I'd prefer to have some really good YouTube friends and a whole bunch of subscribers. But the point is, like, videos have been uploaded so far every day for the last several months. And I still do lose, though, subscribers. I was at 60 now, or I was at 61, now I'm at 60, or 59. So, the YouTube thing, it can be a big headache. Because, especially when you don't know why someone unsubscribed or someone was removed, right? Because sometimes you wish you knew some of the attention of that. I mean, I know sometimes, yes, I can understand, like, to certain people, the quality may have went down, maybe. It's not what they liked anymore. And that all is fine. Sometimes I just wish I knew, though. Like, that way I can know how to improve. Like, at a There was a point where I had a lot of trouble accepting criticism at all, but I'm at a point now that I can't accept constructive criticism. If any of you guys are ever watching my videos and there's something you can suggest to help me improve it, please do. Because, okay, yes, unless you say, play this game series right through and through if I don't like it. Because I'm at a point now, I know that sometimes it's better pleasing other people, but when you think about it, I want to do things that I feel proud of and enjoy. I want it, even though, yes, it wouldn't be possible without you guys, I enjoy your guys' company, I want to make it up kind of about me, right? For myself as well. I mean, some people, yes, you should try new things, like, a lot of people say that to me, and I kind of get where they're going, and I am going to start doing that a little more, but from now on, especially that I'm taking it a little easier with my channel, I'm going to try just to play some new games, try them out to see if I will LP them in the future. I know for sure Super Mystery Dungeon might, just might, be a possibility, but not anytime soon. I know I could have done a let's play of it at this point for the review, but I decided I'm trying to think of how to explain it. It's hard enough, as I said, to record what I recorded, right? Those little bits and pieces that you'll probably see in the review coming up. If I had to record every single thing, every single dungeon side quest, everything, that would take years, maybe, to complete. A year or two, anyway. So I decided and I wouldn't get it done, right? And it's easier for me to be able to play it on the side and then record some important parts. That way, I get it done, I play the game and I get it done, and you get a review on it. I mean, I don't know why, I'm kind of glad that I decided to do this review on it, because it really got me thinking, giving a game another chance another time around. And as I said, I still have my quarrels about the game, but they're not as high as they once were, which is really good. And it's the first time that I ever really paid attention and put a lot of effort into playing a game. You know what I mean? Just for that time being, right? Obviously, I will be under-leveled by the end of it, but I guess that is the point. It'll feel more fulfilling if you are under-leveled for it. So, yeah, as I said, I've been having a pretty interesting experience with the game overall. I'm up to level 15. I said there's still some harder levels coming up, you know what I mean, or areas coming up. And as I said, I am somewhat not looking forward to the Evoltal battle. It's not, that's probably my most dreaded battle. Because, Evoltal can just obliterate you in a single move. I have to really harvest those seeds. That's why I'm definitely going to be doing that. I am going to be going and getting some games, not games, getting some items off my game, you know what I mean, on Pelipper Island, getting, harvesting some tiny Reviver Seeds, maybe Reviver Seeds, and I can use strong level Pokemon so we can just keep going. So as I said, I'm doing my best in it. I'm still recording Mystery Dungeon Gates to Infinity a little bit. I might upload that soon. I don't know. I have to finish off the Explorers of Sky. Because, obviously, I haven't gotten to that for a while. Maybe that'll be tomorrow's project to do some episodes of Explorers of Sky. Maybe, maybe not. Anyway, this will also act as my ending because I have to edit the video and everything. So I will see you guys in my next video.